Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to this e-taster class offered by the School of Health Sciences. My name is Farzida and I am a lecturer for the Diploma in Nursing course at the Ngee Polytechnic. This session is meant for you to get a glimpse of what it's like to study in NP and to find out more about our course. Today, we hope the session on infection control and hand hygiene will be able to share with you the insights of what our nursing students will encounter. At the end of the session, we hope the participants will be able to understand infection control topics as covered by our year one students, importance of hand hygiene, definition of hand hygiene, when and why the need to perform hand hygiene, steps of hand hygiene, and a video demonstration for better understanding. For your information, all our nursing students are taught based on nursing skills book created by our dear lecturers who has been very involved in the care of learning for our students. For the year one, among other topics, infection control also covers performing of medical hand hygiene, using of standard contact airborne and isolation precautions, donning and removing personal protective equipment such as surgical masks, N95 masks, gloves, and even the gowns. Management, general and hazardous waste are also the topic shared to the students. In understanding why is there a need for clean hands or why is there a need to do hand hygiene every now and then, let us have a better awareness by hearing out what the World Health Organization campaign in the year 2020 has to share on the matter. Prof. Didier and Chief Nursing Officer Elizabeth Eero will give us a better insight of why hand hygiene or why clean hands can save lives. Let's have a look.
Welcome all to May the 5th, 2020. The WHO Hand Hygiene Campaign Day. In the context of the current pandemic, hand hygiene is becoming more important than ever to public health. In healthcare facilities, proper hand hygiene with alcohol-based hand rub is one of the main pillars for stopping nosocomial spread of the coronavirus, COVID-19, as well as of all the many other viruses and bacteria found in hospitals and responsible for healthcare-associated infections. These infections affect millions of people per year and cause more deaths than malaria, TB, and AIDS combined. The WHO Save Lives, Clean Your Hands campaign has been celebrated annually on May the 5th since 2009. So far, 142 of the 194 WHO member states have made formal statements pledging their support. More than 20,000 healthcare facilities across 189 countries have committed to improving hand hygiene. There is a special reason why today. I am here with Elizabeth Eero, Chief Nurse Officer at WHO, to introduce you to the 5th of May 2020 campaign. Elizabeth, how is WHO tackling this situation?
This year, the annual 5th May WHO Global Hand Hygiene Campaign is tied to the International Year of the Nurse and the Midwife. Not only do we want to promote good hand hygiene and infection prevention and control practices, we also want to recognise the key role of nurses and midwives in preventing avoidable infection. As the largest group of health workers that provide patient-facing care, nurses and midwives are critical in delivering clean care. In many countries, infection control leaders are typically nurses. Therefore, they have a special place in preventing HAIs. Hand hygiene is the single most effective action you can take to reduce the spread of pathogens and prevent infections, including the COVID-19 virus, all the way from the primary to tertiary level of care. Given their proximity to the patient, nurses and midwives are also the best place to advise patients and families on good hand hygiene practices. In childbirth and neonatal care, midwives practicing good hand hygiene can reduce maternal and neonatal mortality and morbidity. However, as revealed by our State of the World's Nursing Report 2020, nurses and midwives have experienced many challenges in their efforts to provide optimal care, but are too often understaffed, under-resourced, and overworked. The global shortage of nurses and midwives is a major challenge to infection prevention, because insufficient staff level is linked to increased healthcare-associated infections rates. Also, investing in good education and allowing nurses and midwives to practice to the full scope of their license will save lives, improve health outcomes, promote gender equality, and support economic growth. We strongly encourage policymakers to make a greater investment in nurses.
Understand a bit more about hand hygiene. Our nursing students, as I shared, based on the textbook, has been shared often on learning objectives of every lesson learned. The learning objective for hand washing is to be able to demonstrate the correct hand washing technique. Students will also learn the definition, the purpose, and the procedure in very systematic manner, and of course the rationale on the steps. The definition of hand hygiene. Well, hand hygiene is actually a general term that applies to hand washing, antiseptic hand wash, antiseptic hand rub, or surgical hand antiseptic. Hand washing is the vigorous, brief rubbing together of all surfaces of lathered hands, followed by rinsing under a stream of water. Antiseptic hand wash refers to washing hands with detergent containing an antiseptic agent. Antiseptic hand rub refers to applying an antiseptic hand rub product to all surfaces of the hands to reduce the number of microorganisms present. Surgical hand antisepsis refers to antiseptic hand wash or antiseptic hand rub formed before antiseptic, or rather aseptic procedure, to eliminate transient and reduce resident flora. If you are wondering, what's aseptic procedure? Well, basically, it's a very, very clean or sterile procedure needed for the best of care for patients. For example, open skin or like wounds or any form of surgeries done, wounds or any form of ulcers, or other kind of invasive procedures, we can consider as aseptic procedures. The purpose. Learners are being taught about the purposes of every procedure throughout the 3 years of learning. And for hand hygiene, the purpose is to deliver patient care with pathogen-free hands, to prevent the spread of pathogenic microorganisms from patient to patient, environment, or healthcare personnel to patients, to protect patients from cross-contamination, to protect healthcare workers. And of course, in clinical laboratories, we will make the area as close or real situation in the clinical settings, like in the hospital or clinics. So requisites will all be prepared adequately. For example, appropriate liquid disinfectant or soap, paper towels, waste bin, running water, all will be provided and prepared for our learners for the topic on hand hygiene. So every step of it will be in a very systematic manner, as I said, with a procedure going through the assessment, planning, implementation, and evaluation. And for healthcare workers or nursing students, there are 5 moments of hand hygiene. And this is a benchmark to ensure that every time before patient contact, before an aseptic task, after body fluid exposure risk, after patient contact, after contact with patient's surroundings, it has to be done. The hand hygiene has to be done. Why? Well, to protect patient against harmful germs carried on your hands, as we are about to attend to a patient. After we've done aseptic task, we have to do hand hygiene. Why? Because it is to protect patients against harmful germs, including the patient's own germs entering his or her body. After body fluid or exposure risk, we would like, again, hand hygiene to be done. Why? To protect self from any form of harmful patient germs and even the healthcare environment, healthcare workers. After patient contact, is to clean hands with a reason to protect self and healthcare environment once again from any harmful germs. After contact with patient's surroundings, hand hygiene. Why? To protect self, healthcare environment, and from any harmful patient germs once again. So as you can see on the diagram here, these are the 5 moments of hand hygiene our nursing students and healthcare professionals in general all over the world will adhere to ensure clean hands save lives. How to hand rub? Basically, a hand rub is being done when the hands are not visibly soiled. It means you can't see any form of dirt or any fluid or any form of soiled materials on the hands. Then we can do a hand rub. The duration of the entire procedure takes about 20 to 30 seconds. Applying a palmful of the product in a cupped hand, covering all surfaces, as you can see here, is the first step. Then rub hands palm to palm. Right palm over left dorsum, followed by interlaced fingers, and vice versa. Palm to palm with fingers interlaced. Back of fingers to opposing palms with fingers interlocked, vice versa. Rotational rubbing of left thumb clasped in right palm and vice versa. Rotational rubbing backwards and forward with clasped fingers of right hand in left palm and vice versa. After doing the same for the wrist on the left and the right, ensure the hands are dry and safe. How about hand wash? Well, hand wash is being done when visibly soiled. Otherwise, hand rub is off surface. Duration of the hand wash is about 15 to 20 seconds. Duration of the entire procedure will take about 40 to 60 seconds. For our learners, the hand rub will be done 5 strokes for each step. For hand wash, will be 10 strokes for each step. So I will go through in detail with some video demonstration for you to understand better. As for the hand wash, the additional step is wetting hands with water first and taking enough soap, about 5 mils, followed by the steps shared earlier. And towards the end, after rotational rubbing of the clasped fingers of right hand, followed by the other hand and the wrists, the hands will be rinsed with water starting from the fingertips, and the hands are dried thoroughly with a single use of towel, and using the towel to turn off the taps faucet, or if there's a possibility, can use the elbow to close up the faucet, and then the hands are clean and safe. Here is an actual picture that you can see for wetting of hands in a hand washing procedure. Taking a pump of liquid soap, it may be any kind of ordinary mild soap, right palm over left dorsum and left palm over right dorsum, followed by hope this diagram can give better illustration. After wet hands, one pound of liquid soap, palm to palm, then fingers interlaced, right over left dorsum, vice versa, back of fingers opposing palms with fingers interlocked and vice versa, rubbing of right thumb clasped in left palm, vice versa, rotational rubbing or backwards and forward, clasp fingers in right hand and palm, vice versa, rotational rubbing of the right wrist clasped in left palm and vice versa, followed by rinsing under running water, keeping fingers pointing upwards. Rinsing in the direction of fingers to wrist to forearm. Dry hands thoroughly with a paper towel while keeping hands positioned with fingers pointing up. Let me share with you a video demonstration that we share with our students. Well, I hope you have a better understanding of what to be done when you clean your hands, be it hand rub or hand wash. Basically, the steps of hand hygiene we shared earlier targeted at different aspects of the hands. What you see in the circles with yellow highlighted color is the areas that are targeted for cleaning away from any form of pathogens or microorganisms. And if effectively done, the hand washing would be a very proper Well, we hope you have a better understanding after looking at what has been shared over the video demonstration. So the steps of hand hygiene, basically targeting over different aspects of the hands, as you can see in this pictures. Those highlighted in yellow, in those circles, are the areas that we are targeting comprehensively to clean the hands from any form of pathogens or microorganisms. By doing so, we will have clean hands to save lives, and we will definitely stop from contaminating one another or cross-contaminating from one place to another. We truly hope you find this brief sharing beneficial. And remember, clean hands save lives. We thank you for your attention and your patience to be with us. We hope if you do have any further queries or wish to find out more about our courses, do check out our course highlights on NP's virtual open house website. You may also join the one-to-one chats with our lecturers or chat with our NP student ambassadors on Telegram. You may access these chats through our Ngee Ann Polytechnic open house website. Thank you and have a great day ahead.